Hi, everyone. In this video, we're going to talk about how you can get hot module reloading working with Next.js in a Docker environment. If you've ever used Next.js before, you're probably familiar with this feature. And so what it is that in your Next.js folder, if you make changes and you have the web server running, you will then see the changes immediately reflected in the web server running on your computer in your local environment. If you've tried to Dockerize the Next.js application, what you might see is that you make these changes and they don't actually get reflected up in your Docker environment. In fact, the previous blog series that we did, which was full stack with Next.js and Prisma 2, the hot module reloading functionality didn't actually work. And so we're going to fix that today. And then we're also going to show you how, if you have just a brand new Next.js application, how you can get this working. So let's get started. So what you can do is you can go to the GitHub repo of the Prisma 2 blog that we were working on previously. And so here's the link up here. You can just click on the clone button and you can copy this and you can do a git clone to be able to pull this. And so I want to show you in Gitkraken exactly where we are so you can make sure you pull the right version. And so you can see that I made a commit. It was on 8/18/2019 and it was called added hot module reload. And so if you come back to this in the future and there are additional commits later, it's no problem. All you have to do is you can just right-click on this and you can go reset staging to this commit and you can do like a hard. And so you can kind of check out this particular state that the application's in. So since this is the most recent commit, I can just use the latest on staging right now. So the first thing that you need to do is you need to ensure that the Dockerfile for your Next.js application is set up correctly. So when we open up the project in VS Code, there's a backend and a frontend folder. So you want to make sure that you're looking at this Dockerfile here that's in your frontend. We're starting with this Node 10 base image. We're then creating a working directory that we're calling app. And we're just copying in our package.json and our package lock.json into this working directory, and we're running an npm install. The command that we run to get our app up and running is called npm run dev. You'll notice that one thing that is missing from this, which we want to just keep out for now, is a line where we're copying all of the files in. And so we want to make sure that all of this code is making its way into the Docker container using volume mapping and not by simply copying this. Once you have everything working, you can add the copy back here. And this will be good for like production environments because you won't want the volume mapping of your source code on a computer to the Docker container. But just so that we're really clear about what's happening, just leave it off for now. So you can use this as your Docker file. So the next thing that we want to do is we want to make sure that the front end is set up correctly in our Docker Compose. And so we can see that we're exposing port 3000 here, which is exactly what we want. We're building from the Docker file that we just showed you. What's important here is that the volumes needs to be set up correctly. So you can see that there's this volume section within our front end, and that we're mapping the entire front end folder into the app folder of a running Docker container. And so if we just left it at that, the app actually wouldn't run because the node modules in the next folder that the Docker container would build when you're doing the npm install and you're actually starting up your next application, it wouldn't be there. So we need to add these two additional volume that are after this front end to app mapping. And so what this ensures is that we first will map the front end folder to our app directory that's inside the running container. And then after that is done, we will then map on top of that the node modules in the next. So that means that when we're building our Docker image and we're creating the running Docker container, that the files generated during this npm install step and also this run dev step will get saved off into these folders inside the container, and then we will use them. So I know that was kind of confusing, but the main point is that the only thing we're doing inside this Docker file is we're just installing all the dependencies, but we're not copying in any of our source code into this at the moment. And so the only way that it's getting in is then through this particular this line here, which is the volume mapping that we're setting up between our front end directory and our app directory with inside the Docker container. So then the last step that we need to do is we need to add a block to the next.config.js file. And so it's this one right here. It's web dev middleware. And so we can set a polling frequency. This is how often the Next application will look for changes in the files. So it will check once a second to see if you made any changes. And then there'll be like a timeout of 300 milliseconds. And then it will kind of rebuild your entire app. You'll notice that with this particular settings, the hot reloading might be slightly slower than it would be if it was outside the Docker container. But I think this is a good compromise. You really only need to kind of check it once a second. First, we can build the application. Then we can start it. And when we see the front end starting, we see that there should be a line that says webpack dev middleware config function defined in Next.js, and that it's using that. That's awesome. This is exactly what we wanted. So then once it finishes, we should be able to just load the website. This is great. So we can see that the web page loaded just as we expected. So I should be able to just use it as I'd expect normally. So I can see that I can add a user. But what we can do now is we can make a small change, and we can see that it will be updated immediately on the website. So let me go and change this title here. So that title is defined in pages, folder, and then the index. And so I can just try changing this from blog example to examples. So I can save this. And what I can see is that in the console that it ended up rebuilding this. And so now when I go to Google Chrome, we can see that it got updated immediately. So here's an example then of how you can create hot module reloading in Next.js when it's running inside of a Docker container. So you needed to make changes to all three of those files. And so that was the Dockerfile, the docker-compose, and then also in the config file for the Next.js application. So I hope that helps, and let me know what you think. Thanks for watching.